So, good morning, dear colleagues. I see that we have a lot of guests today. So today we are going to speak about space exploration. I'm Mashinets Tatiana, English teacher of NISA IB from Astana. So the topic of the lesson is and presentation is space exploration past and future, but mostly we are going to discuss with the students maybe this is the place of the Kazakhstan in this space exploration. What have you seen? So what will you see? You will see today some objectives from the COST program, and you see that the information should be connected with, as it given in our COST plan, mostly with Russian and American space missions or programs. But we shall add, the topic of the lesson is focus on Kazakhstan. So the context is connected with such a kind of great event like the first flight of a man into the space. And you remember it was on the 12th of April. We had anniversary of this a tremendous step of the mankind, and it is also useful like the information. I have chosen key learning objectives from the course program. You see them. Mostly it is connected with the speaking and organizing and presenting information. So at the same time, I would like to give the tasks connected with the usage of imagination to express thoughts, ideas, experiences, and feelings. For the lesson itself, I have chosen not all of them, but only some. You will see the next. So, list of useful vocabulary. As the lesson connected with such a kind of topic like scientific a little bit, so I suggest you to find out space words, ready lists of the words in these resources according to these references. So, of course, if you are interested in something special about space exploration topic, you, of course, you can use your own list of words. But I think these lists will be useful because they are connected with the topic from different aspects. So what topics will be included into the lesson, and what is possible to discuss on the lesson? Of course, it is the first question will be, or the first topic will be, necessity of space exploration for people and how we can realize this process. So the second is the 55th anniversary of the first flight into space, and it is connected with Yuri Gagarin and maybe some information about his life. Then Baikonur history and the place of Kazakhstan in the space of in the space exploration. So where are we as a country who can provide great opportunities to explore the space? So then it can be about international space projects, and I have chosen maybe a smaller sphere, space stations. I think it also will be interesting for the students. As medical language is included into the lesson, so it is useful to discuss health problems of space explorers from the point of medical terms, maybe. And of course, I think it is very necessary for the students to discuss perspectives of the space exploration connected with the project of the school children in this sphere. So our students participated in different project programs connected with the space and or maybe researches useful for the space. So I think that it is possible to find out some information. And one more interesting topic for today's space programs is the topic about space tourism. So necessity requirements to the candidates. necessity of the space tourism will be connected maybe with the general necessity of space exploration in general, and requirements to the candidates is possible to connect with the health problems of space explorers also. So these are topics to discuss on the lesson. And what else? So what kind of activities? So for my lesson, I have chosen some activities, individual this time, maybe pair. It depends on the teacher, of course, but my suggestions. And group work, during which they will show their skills in self-organization, in their skills in organizing thoughts, ideas, visions. The next skill will be connected with the ability to justify giving evidences using their imagination. At the same time, it can be speaking, because they will present posters according to the idea of the lesson. And individual work will be writing associations or drawing associations, but I will tell about this a little bit later. Group work, presentations, and then at the end of the lesson, as usual, reflection in any kind. So during this lesson, it is possible to use some videos. I have found videos connected with the first with the impressions of the first space tourist, Tito. He explained the ideas of what it means to be the space tourist. Then it is possible to find videos about especially such a kind of people as Yuri Gagarin, maybe Armstrong, American cosmonaut, stepping first on the moon. And of course, sorry to say, but I didn't find videos connected with our Kazakhstan cosmonauts, but I think it is possible. So it is about the activities. What else? I suggest you some photos. You see, it is this photo is about international workshop Space Days in Kazakhstan. It is about 2014 or 2013, but it is like illustration that Kazakhstan is very active in this sphere, and he provides the place and maybe the ground for discussion, scientific ideas connected with the space exploration. So you see the guests of this seminar workshop, our cosmonaut. So space stations, it is equipment of the cosmonauts or astronauts. Again, it is telescope Hubble, and people and cosmonauts walking outside the space station. So then you will find, I think, enough references to the useful information connected with space exploration. It is begun with the information about our state of events in our country. Then there will be information about Russian works. Then it will be information from different sites of Great Britain, mostly, if I'm not mistaken. Yes, it is connected with the exploration of outer space, then with requirements to the cosmonauts and tourists, which should be used during the space flight. So, it is general information about what you can use to prepare this lesson. And as for the lesson itself, so the plan of the lesson will be connected with individual and group work of the students. And I think that it depends, as a note to the lesson, I should say that everything will depend on the student's level of the language and their maybe a type of thinking. So it depends on the teacher in what way he will conduct this lesson and what activities to take, what kind of maybe tasks. So the lesson which I suggest to your attention doesn't connect any vocabulary works. And I thought about it like maybe the final lesson due to this topic. So for me, it is interesting when students are speaking mostly, expressing their ideas, maybe showing their imagination and their ability to justify the facts and thoughts. So that's why the aims for the space exploration and Kazakhstan, it is the topic of the lesson. I have chosen three of them, and so they are: encourage students to create own vision of real world events, and it is connected with the space exploration. Then develop skills in creative and critical thinking. They will be giving ideas during the lesson and their arguments. They will compare something, they will analyze. It is it is a special part of the process of their work. So, and the third aim will be develop skills in public speaking. They will present their posters. So, what kind of approaches to learning will be developed during this lesson? I think that it will be very convenient to develop their communication skills. So, it means they will communicate with the teacher one thing, in groups the second thing, and they will give oral communication in the way of presenting their posters. Then the second approach is thinking, skills in comparison, logics of their ideas, justifications, evidences, giving the right, maybe to their opinion, of course, ideas for how everything should be connected with the space exploration. And of course, it is self-organization and time management. Time management, of course, it is the maybe not obligation, but it is the task of the teacher. And self-organization, it is it can be supervised by the teacher, but of course, it is the responsibility of the students themselves in what way they will organize their individual work and they organize their group work. So, as for the next, lesson can be divided in two parts. It depends, of course, because while thinking about it, I decided that maybe two lessons will be enough if we want students to be ready to speak confidently in public. So, the tasks, time management, and differentiation, everything depends on the group itself, and you know your students as anyone else. So it depends on you, your ideas, and on the skills of your groups and how your group used to work. So, and the main idea for this lesson is during the whole lesson, students should use the previous knowledge connected with the space, with the exploration, with other subjects maybe knowledge. It is physics, as it was written in the course program, physics, chemistry, biology, but they should give it in a generated way, and they present their vision of space exploration. Not maybe in Kazakhstan, but who knows, maybe they will be space scientists and it will help them. They will give their ideas, and we should remember that we can't say that your opinion is not right or your opinion is close to the right. So it's better to say that in this way they will be giving the ideas for themselves to further exploration of this topic if it is interesting for them. So what about the course of the lesson? The warming up of this lesson, I think, can be connected with the reflection of the previous knowledge. So it is possible to do in different way, but I offer, for example, to do such a kind of task. Individually, student will write from 1 to 3 ideas, words, maybe associations connected with the word space. What is space for them? How they understand it? What is in their head connected with the word space? Or maybe sky, skies at night with the stars, and they can draw a kind of symbol of the space. So you know that symbol is something little but very exact connected with the topic, so they can maybe provide their own idea of the symbol. So they will do it individually, but they do not discuss it for some period of time. It is a kind of maybe introduction to the lesson, to the speaking. And the next part of the warming up can be a class discussion when the teacher is asking questions for the students. Such a kind of questions, for example, as what do you know about space? How you understand or what is outer space, then what was the event connected with the space on the 12th of April, what do you know about space exploration in Kazakhstan, so what do these people have in common, and you can show maybe the photos of Gagarin, Armstrong and Musabayev. So each of these questions can be asked in general and to check up their previous knowledge maybe or ideas connected with the space exploration, or it can be given maybe like a very short task for doing individually or in pairs. Why not? It's according to the teacher's creativity. So in my way, I will discuss like teacher student 1, student 2, student 3, in order to get maybe them ready to discuss some problems or to give them ideas for the further lesson. After this discussion, I suggest you, for example, to conduct such a kind of individual work as creative, it will be a kind of creative thinking, but it will be expressed in the pictures which the students will draw themselves. And so it will be, task will be, so after the discussion with the whole group, so you give the task, draw any ideas you have in your head, as any associations on A4, it is possible, connected with the space, exploration, with everything to discuss, useful to discuss during the lesson. So the idea of this drawing is after after drawing such a kind of pictures, I hope that some students will draw maybe something general about the space itself. Some students maybe will draw, oh, I do not know, maybe the first man in outer space. So it is, it will be the place maybe or the time to remember that Gagarin was the first person who flew into the space, and he was on the orbit for some period of time, very short, but the first person who was out of the spaceship in the space was Russian cosmonaut Leonov, and after that there was Armstrong on the moon and so on. So everything can be connected. So I think that creativity and imagination of our students is great. So, but I hope that some of them will draw something connected with Baikonur, Kazakhstan, maybe some environmental problems, some maybe ideas about future medicine in the cosmos, in the space. So that's why everything will be useful. So after the students draw this picture, and while they draw this picture, of course, I think it will be very pleasant for them and for the teacher himself or herself, so to use the music connected with the space. So of course, we have different maybe ideas about what is space music, but As far as I know, in YouTube it is possible to find real sounds of the space. At the same time, some kind of electronical music also connected with the space. And the music is not very bad, very different, of course, on the taste of the teacher maybe and the students. But nevertheless, it is possible to use music during students are drawing pictures. So it will help them. So, and while they are doing this, the only thing is the time. How much time are you going to give them? That will be the question. And so if it is more than maybe, if it is about 10 minutes or maybe more than 10 minutes, maybe you will choose some pieces of the music. Why not? So after this individual work, again, for a while, without any discussions, you divide your students into groups. Again, division into the groups depends on the group, depends on the teacher's ideas. I do not know, it can be done with the help of pictures of the planets. Do you know this planet? Who knows this planet? Or maybe some kind of short quiz about space exploration, very famous facts, maybe. It depends. So the main idea is that if it is a lesson about space, I think everything should be connected with the space. So what about group work? So group work will take the most part of the lesson, the most time of the lesson. Why? Because a kind of maybe some requirements for the group work. The first will be the students divided in the groups should at first share their, you remember that they wrote associations connected with the word space, then they draw a picture, and so they should share in the groups with their personal information. So with their ideas, in short, they should say why they think so, or it is simple, I decided to draw this, or I decided to write this, because I like it. Of course, because I like it, it is not a good answer. But nevertheless, it is possible to save the time if you want. So they in groups will present their ideas about the space from warming up and their pictures, which they draw during the musical pause, maybe. And in the groups, they should create a collage connected with all their pictures and ideas. So you should say to the students at once that there is no not necessary pictures or not necessary ideas. They must include each picture of the member of the group, almost each ideas into their maybe joint post and poster. So why? Because this creative ideas of the students, individual ideas and their pictures will be a kind of maybe spheres they are going to discuss in the connection with our topic space exploration. So they will put it, in what way they will be doing it, it depends on their imagination and it depends on how they think, what is the most important, what is not most important, but everything should be included. And the main requirement maybe for this task will be to use their creative thinking, their critical thinking, and they should explain their poster from the point of all the pictures. So, of course, if you want to connect the whole lesson only with Kazakhstan information, then you can give the task to draw individually thoughts, ideas, pictures connected only with Kazakhstan and the Kazakhstan space in Kazakhstan place in the space exploration. It is also possible, but to my mind, I think it's better to connect Kazakhstan with other countries, leaders maybe in the space exploration, in order to compare them. in order to compare them. So then they will be, they can name, sorry, for 1 minute. So they can name their project in any way you like, or they like. But you can suggest them such kind of topics as maybe development of space science, or mankind and space, space exploration, Kazakhstan and space, everything. So, but you can only mention that the title of their poster should present the idea of whole group work. And one more idea you should tell to your students, you should remind them that every person, while presenting the poster, every person should speak what they decide to speak. So, in the case if your students a little bit maybe not informed about the space exploration, you can give them different questions to help with their presentation. So the possible question can be, why do people strive to fly into the space? Or what can the exploration of the space give to a separate country or to the world as a whole? Why is it necessary to explore the space? Who can be a spaceman? And what are the characteristics of cosmonaut? Should cosmonaut be healthy and educated, and why, in what way, and so on? It is, again, it is only samples of the questions. The next, why is the space tourism so popular in the modern world, and requirements for the space tourist? So space tourism is a special maybe sphere in the space exploration. And you know that I read some information that if at the first flight to the space cost about some millions, now it was written in the information found me in the net that now it is limited to $100,000 of course. Then there are special requirements to the tourist, the height, the weight, even the size of the feet has the importance. So the next question to help them maybe to organize their thoughts maybe, how can the young people and school children be useful for space exploration? What are the consequences of being cosmonauts? Problems with psychology, health, and then space and Kazakhstan, reality and future, cosmonauts of Kazakhstan. So, of course, it is only some of the sample questions. It is possible, maybe in order to organize work of the group more effectively, maybe it will be useful to create some questions and give them on the sheets of paper for each group, different of them. But you should think about this beforehand, about the questions. But nevertheless, while at the lesson, you will see in what maybe direction each group will be working, and maybe then select the questions specially for them. But I think that if even if you do not ask these questions, the creativity and imagination of the students will help them to discuss the problems, because the whole lesson will be connected with the discussions, with the ideas presenting, using the students' vision of this future of any country. So what else can be discussed during the lesson? Of course, during the lesson, you can discuss some information connected with the maybe Kazakhstan work with other countries in the space exploration. Of course, on the first place, it is Russia. Then it can be China, as it was written in the news. So in 2015, that they are also going to cooperate their space activities. Kazakhstan and China. What else possible? In the internet, you can find an article about our cosmonaut Aydin Aimbekov, about his life dream or great ambition to be cosmonaut from his childhood, and how he maybe how he came to the realization of his idea. It is also possible to find. It will be also interesting. What else? Then, of course, it may be some information about Baikonur Cosmodrome. You know, it is not maybe very simple question. Baikonur and its place in not only in our space exploration, in Kazakhstan space exploration, but also it is it plays a great role in the Russian space exploration programs, because all the researchers, all launches of any space stations or cosmonauts are done from this great place. So of course you can give them information that in 1955 Baikonur was founded, and at first it was like a center for as it is written in the information in Wikipedia, a test center for the world's first intercontinental ballistic missiles. So, but in some period of time, of course, it became great place, close place maybe for the public, but nevertheless very developed. We know that there are some problems with the renting or of this place, but nevertheless, it is possible to discuss. Maybe the students know some information. What else? You can discuss what people can find on Baikonur territory, the special place for the launching of the spaceships. And you can mention about Baikonur Museum. As it is written in Wikipedia, it is a small museum located next to the small two cottages, and it is the residences of Sergei Korolev and Yuri Gagarin. And so, as it is written in the information, all the exhibits in the museum are authentic. So, of course, you can mention that almost every year, Kazakhstan is conducting some international workshops, like this you see in the picture, Space Days in Kazakhstan. Now it is a big scientific conference, not only workshop, it is conference with inviting international representatives of this science, and great discussions of different aspects of the space exploration. So everything depends on the teacher. So while students are working at their college, they discuss. I think it is also possible to use the music, or maybe you can prepare some presentations, or maybe if you want to be the lesson more productive, it is possible before this lesson to give the task for the students to prepare some information or to find some pictures. Or maybe you will give individually to the students different questions about the space to be ready to find out maybe short information. Some news about space exploration, like world maybe event, and like one of the part of our country. After some period of time, after the group finished their work, again, you should remind them that in their presentations, of their posters, we should see and we should understand that it's their individual vision, like a group, and they can think globally, because space exploration is very important topic, not only for one country, but for the whole mankind. And we know that from time to time, in the mass media the topic of great journey to other countries are discussed with scientific with a scientist, or you know, you can connect it with new information that on the Mars there was found water. Who knows? But nevertheless, you should inform them and remind them that they should use their own ideas based on their knowledge from different subjects also. If they want to underline or emphasize some information from physics or biology, why not? But they should explain why. So the whole their ideas, each direction of their group posters should be explained why they think so and why they see it in this way. So presentations, again, as for presentations, it depends on the teacher how much time you want them to speak. I think that if there are five students in the group and each person will be speaking about 1 minute, it is 5 minutes for the group, how many groups and so on. It is a simple calculation. But maybe you will see that the students will be speaking more than your limit. So I think it's better not to stop them and give the opportunity to express their ideas, because I hope that space exploration is a very interesting topic for them. And they will give you great ideas. So they will present their posters in the way they think useful. If it is possible, if you have the opportunity, you can allow them using the laptops on the lessons to find maybe information, maybe music, maybe other pictures, I do not know. But the main attention should be their own presentations of the pictures and ideas which they created at the beginning of the lesson. While one group is presenting, it is also possible to do the requirement that if one group has already given the idea of other group, do not repeat it, or you can repeat it only if you have something special to add. It also will help you to economize your time if it is so important for you, or it will show them that it's better not to repeat the same ideas. Only in the case if they have different justifications, different evidences, only in this case they can repeat the idea. What else? Everything depends on the at this moment in the public presentations. Of course, if they know how to present, how to be confident, how to be persuasive, they can use this knowledge also, because our idea is not only to use their previous knowledge connected with other subjects, but we should develop their speaking. So they should be ready at any time maybe in their life to discuss any topic without any preparation. But from one side, of course, this poster's presentation will be a kind of prepared or rehearsed speech, but it is possible, because you should say that on the poster they should give only pictures or short phrase connected with the directions they are going to discuss and nothing else. Because sometimes our students like to put the whole information in the poster or slides and simply read it from the screen or from the paper. So it is impossible. The strict requirement will be speaking. So while the one group is presenting, others can maybe assess their work. It is also possible to do according to their own ideas, individual ideas of the students, in what way they are going to assess the presentations. Or it can be individual maybe task, or it can be group task. So if it is a group task, it means that they should discuss beforehand what points they are going to maybe to assess in the presentations of other groups. And of course, after presenting their own posters, they also should write a kind of self-assessment. In what way presentations was good, was bad, or was it maybe informative? Was the material or information so-called fresh, and so on? It depends. Or the teacher can give them a special form what to assess during the presenting posters, and it also should be given before the presenting. So after the presentations, I think that the presentations of the students will be interesting, and some ideas will be maybe unusual. Maybe even we do not think about the space exploration in the way the students think. Of course, during presentations, do not forget to make notes of interesting ideas, or maybe how well they justify, maybe topics which you even didn't expect them to discuss. It will be a good maybe base for the further discussion for the next lesson, like reflection of the lesson. So after the presentation, you can do the reflection as usual after each lesson, or it depends on the topic. And the reflection again can be done in different ways. Maybe you will ask them to write something. Maybe they will tell you in oral way their impressions. Maybe you will ask them to write questions appeared or emerged in their heads while the presentations, and they would like them to discuss further in the connection with this topic. Everything depends on the group, on their level, and the ideas of the teacher. So, but I think, of course, it is necessary to reflect. Very easy question you should ask: did you like this lesson and why? So they should write what they like in the lesson, as usual, but they should explain why they like, what they like. Do they like maybe group work? Why? Again, individual work. Again, they should explain why. So this kind of reflection, it's better, I think, to, as for reflection, I think it's better to make it in the written way, because you are always, you always can find a lot of ideas and thoughts for the next discussions connected with this topic, or maybe some of the students will ask questions, maybe for the first sight, not connected with the space exploration, but nevertheless very important to discuss on the next lesson. And at the same time, these reflections, do not forget that we can use these reflections while we are thinking about the programs for the next year, or maybe for further ideas of this lesson. So, as I said, every lesson depends on the teacher's creativity and teacher's ideas of thinking, maybe, and the main idea of each lesson should be what I want from my students. Do I want them reading and retelling, or do I want them to be intellectual future maybe of the country, and this intellectual future should express their ideas, should justify, should give evidences, but they can do it in a confident and maybe even do not forget about the polite way. So as for the lesson, it is all what I wanted to present you today. So if you have some questions, you can write, or you can ask the questions. I will answer all of them. It will be very interesting to know maybe your impressions about the ideas of the lessons. Maybe from one side the lesson is not great, but nevertheless we shouldn't forget that each lesson is a kind of formative work preparing students for the further development of their skills in gaining knowledge. Thank you very much for your attention. Goodbye.